everyone. Tricado's Catering and Events is back in the house. Chef ROD from Chefs in the Hood invited me back to cook y'all a delicious meal again. Don't forget to subscribe, like our page. Today we're going to be cooking a slow cooked curry butternut squash stew. And let's come look at some of the ingredients that we're using today. We have the red lentils that we've already soaked and rinsed and cleaned. We got coconut milk. We got vegetable broth base. It's also concentrated. We got some curry powder, turmeric, cardamom. We got some of our onions cut already. We also got some scallions, some lemon zest. We're going to also use some lemon juice, fresh lemon juice. We got the grated ginger already, some salt, pepper, diced tomatoes, virgin olive oil. Also, some vegetable broth. You can make it with water, but I think it will come out better with the, it comes out better with the vegetable broth. And of course, our butternut squash. So let's get started. Let's get this butternut squash cut up, and then we'll get everything put into the crock pot, and let's see how this comes out. Okay, I'm peeling this butternut squash. I usually cut the top and the bottom off. It just makes it easier to peel with it being so large. Okay, so let's get started cutting this butternut squash. Take your time. Make sure you have a heavy knife, sharp, and just take your time. Cut in half. Okay, now the first thing we're gonna do, once we got it cut in half, we're gonna start gutting it out, taking out all the seeds, okay? Seeds that are in here can also be baked in the oven, just like pumpkin seeds or sunflower seeds. You could, same as you would do nuts, anything. So if you want, you can always save them and they go for a good snack. Okay, let's get this butternut chopped over so we can cut it. I'm gonna finish cutting up the rest of this butternut squash. You want them to be about a half an inch in the size. Okay, so now we have everything prepped, cut, and ready to go. So now we're just gonna start adding it to our crock pot. We're gonna start with the butternut squash. Our onions. Our green onions. Start adding the lemon zest, curry powder, turmeric, the ground cardamom, our grated ginger, now our coconut milk. Diced tomatoes. See how simple this is? Lovely. You have to love a crock pot. We also have our olive oil. Vegetable broth, that's what's next. Now once we get everything in here, we're gonna mix it up very well. But I'm still not done, I still have to put the lemon juice in. Now we're going to add some salt and pepper to taste. I'm not going to put in a lot now because there's a lot of seasoning in here already, but you can always add some later, about maybe like an hour before it's going to end, because this is going to cook for 8 hours. So about at 7 hours, you want to check it out, taste it, see if it's at the flavor you want. If you need more seasoning, then you could add it at that time. It's always better to start off with less than to start off with too much. Oh, and oh my God, I almost forgot. Magic potion, the vegetable base. Don't worry, my hands are clean. Okay, now let's get this all stirred up and mixed up together very well. And then all we have to do is turn the crock pot on, put it on high, on low, sorry, for 8 hours. Or you could do it at high for 4 hours. But I want it to cook slowly, so this will be done just in time. Now all of that is mixed up very well. You see that? At 8 hours. So now it's cooking. Once it's finished, it'll go straight to warming, just in case I'm not ready to go back to it right away. But I will come and check it once we're at 7 hours to see how it tastes, if I need to add something a little bit more. We'll be back. Okay, so here we are, we're back. Our slow cooked curry butternut squash stew is finally done. Come take a look at what the finish. Oh, by the way, yes, when I put everything in the crock pot, I forgot to put the lentils in, but they were put in right after we cut. So the red lentils has been added. Okay, now here's the finished product. You see all of that? It's gonna taste delicious. You can see the tomatoes, the lentil, the butternut squash, green onions, everything is in there that we put. So right now we're gonna plate it up and we're gonna do a tasting, my favorite part. I have some rice that I've already made. Place this right on top of the rice, just like you would do any other stew. There you go. Now we're gonna take some of these green onions and put some green onions on top, just for a little bit extra flavor. And this is a very simple vegan dish that you can make, and it actually tastes delicious. Okay. And like I said, it's cooked in the crock pot, so everything is done for you already. You don't even have to do much other than prep it, put it in, and sit it aside and let it cook. So now let's taste it. I need a spoon. Now remember, I told you, you could taste it at 7 hours. If you want a little bit more salt or pepper, you can add it in then and let it cook for another hour. Okay? Here we go. Delicious. So subscribe, like Chefs in the Hood. Let us know, try the recipe out. Let us know if you do a little tweaking to the recipe, but let us know how it comes out for you. See you again. I'm gonna continue eating.